previous class we learned about remainder theorem. What is that remainder theorem? If any polynomial p of x is divided by another linear polynomial x minus a, then p of a will be the remainder. Then in this session we learn another theorem, that is factor theorem, that is on the basis of that remainder theorem. Then I have written the statement of factor theorem here. If p of x is a polynomial of degree n greater than or equal to 1 and a is any real number, then first statement, x minus a is a factor of p of x if p of a is equal to 0. And second statement, p of a is equal to 0 if x minus a is a factor of p of x. Then we will prove these two statements on the basis of our remainder theorem. Then what is our remainder theorem? If p of x is divided by x minus a, then p of x is equal to x minus a whole into q of x plus r, for r, only r, remainder. So here in the first statement, it is given that p of a is equal to 0. According to our remainder theorem, we know p of a is the remainder. So here remainder is equal to 0. So this implies p of x is equal to x minus a whole into q of x. As r is equal to 0. So here it is proved that p of x is equal to x minus a whole into q of x. That means the product of two polynomials. So here it is proved that x minus a is a factor of p of x. Then second statement. This is the proof of first statement. Then what is second statement? What is given here? Here it is given that x minus a is a factor of p of x. That implies x minus a is a factor of p of x. So this implies p of x is equal to x minus a multiplied with g of x. So where g of x is a polynomial. So what is p of a? We have to find, we have to prove p of a is equal to 0. So p of a is equal to a minus a whole into g of x. So this becomes 0. So these two statements we have proved on the basis of remainder theorem. Then let us solve some examples based on factor theorem. This example is like this. Examine whether x plus 2 is a factor of polynomial x cube plus 3x square plus 5x plus 6 and 2x plus 4. So what is our factor theorem? If a polynomial p of x is divided by x minus a, if p of a is equal to 0, then x minus a is a factor of p of x. So here x minus a, in place of x minus a, this is x plus 2. So we have to find p of minus 2. So let p of x is equal to x cube plus 3x square plus 5x plus 6. Now to verify whether x plus 2 is a factor of p of x or not, we have to find p of minus 2. So what is p of minus 2? Minus 2 cube plus 3 multiplied with minus 2 square plus 5 multiplied with minus 2 plus 6. So this is equal to minus 8 plus 12 minus 10 plus 6. So this is equal to 0. So p of minus 2 is equal to 0. So this implies x plus 2 is a factor of x cube plus 3x square plus 5x. Then test for second polynomial. Let q of x is equal to 2x plus 4. So here also we have to find p of minus 2, q of minus 2. So what is q of minus 2? 2 multiplied with minus 2 plus 4. a is a factor of a polynomial p of x, then p of a will be equal to 0. So here we have to, if p of x is equal to 4x cube plus 3x square minus 4x plus k, then we have to find p of 1 is equal to, it should be 0. If x minus 1 is a factor of this polynomial, then p of 1 is equal to 0. As x minus 1 is a factor of p of x. So we have to count p of 1. So what is p of 1? 4 multiplied with 1 cube plus 3 multiplied with 1 square minus 4 multiplied with 1 plus k. So this is equal to 4 plus 3 minus 4 plus k. This is equal to 3 plus k. So p of 1 is equal to 0. So this implies 3 plus k is equal to 0. So this implies k is equal to minus 3. So if x minus 1 is a factor of this polynomial p of x, then k should be minus 3. Next example, factorize y square minus 5y plus 6 by using factor theorem. So we can do it by the splitting of middle term, but here the question is use factor theorem. We know that let p of y is equal to y square minus 5y plus 6. So if p of y is equal to y minus a multiplied with y minus b, then there will be a constant term, a b. There will be a constant term, a b. So here, a b is equal to 6. So we have to test for the factors of 6. What are the factors of 6?
Plus 1, minus 1.
minus becomes 0. So if P of 1 is equal to 0, so this implies x minus 1 is a factor of P of x. So this implies P of x is equal to x minus 1 into Q of x. X minus 1 multiplied with Q of x. So to find Q of x, we have to divide P of x by x minus 1. So what is our P of x? X cube minus 23x square plus 142x minus 120. So divide it by x minus 1. So here x square, we got P of x is equal to x minus 1 multiplied with x square minus 22x plus 120. So this is equal to x minus 1. We can factorize this polynomial by splitting of middle term. So this is x square minus 12x minus 10x plus 120. Equal to x minus 1 whole into x minus 12 minus 10 into x minus 12. So this is equal to x minus 1 whole into x minus 12 into x minus 10. So this is our P of x. So this is the result. So by using factor theorem, you can factorize any polynomial.